so here we are at the Lester G. McNamara Wildlife Management Area. It's kind of split by the Tuckahoe River, with half of it in the Atlanta County side and half on the Cape May County side, where we are now in Upper Township. We have 6 waterfowl impoundments that total about 950 acres. They were initially built in the 1940s, designed by one of our previous waterfowl biologists, Lester G. McNamara, who ultimately became one of our directors. Given that these impoundments are old, they've become dysfunctional. They don't drain properly. They really don't function the way we need them to, where we classically will raise and lower water levels to grow aquatic plants to benefit waterfowl and shorebirds and all sorts of other critters. So we've worked cooperatively with Ducks Unlimited and Cape May County Mosquito Commission on this project. We've gotten a North American Wetlands Conservation Act, often called NOCA, a $1 million grant, which Ducks Unlimited has taken the lead on. And we're installing these water control structures to put these impoundments back to a full functionality, which is what they need to for proper waterfowl management.
We're really excited to see water control structures going in and seeing progress underway. We're especially excited because we'll be able to begin to manage these impoundments like they were back in the past, be able to move water in and out, kind of target those forage items that will be able to, you know, hopefully bring those birds back in the numbers where, you know, they had been historically whenever they had managed it. If we get the management regime in, I will be able to, you know, bring a lot more hunting opportunity to the area that is really nice to take advantage of. So looking forward to that for sure.
The way these control structures work, there's individual stop gates inside that allow water in or water out. So depending which way you have the stop gates oriented inside the control structure is how much salt water will be allowed inside the impoundment and how much flow comes out. So it gives us the ability to keep a consistent water height for whatever season or whatever species we're managing for at the time.
Going on behind me is a result of a series of projects that have been going on as far as the Southeast New Jersey Coastal Initiative, which has been a consortium of partners between the state, New Jersey Division of Fish and Wildlife, Ducks Unlimited, the Nature Conservancy, and many others. In total, we've had about $1 million raised toward this project, and as well as matching funds coming from the state and other sources. But this has been an ongoing effort, and to date we've already been successfully introducing phases 2 and phase 3 of the Southeast New Jersey Coastal Initiative. Altogether, it'll be reaching about 5,000 acres of new wildlife management areas, as well as Cape May National Wildlife Refuge, Sapona Meadows National Wildlife Refuge, and a series of different restoration projects. So this project has been important for Ducks Unlimited for many reasons. Coastal marshes are of a strong importance for us here in the Mid-Atlantic and North Atlantic regions. Part of our Completing the Cycle initiative, eventually giving these birds the resources they need to make their annual migration from the breeding grounds down to the wintering grounds here and make it back in good health and body condition. We got quite a few different species that would benefit from this. By far our most important that we're looking to create habitat and importance of habitat is our North American black duck species, but certainly a lot of our other coastal species that utilize these impoundments, such as different skulk species, buffleheads, mergansers, mallards, gadwall, pintails. It'll be a wide variety of different species that'll benefit from the support of this project.